Hey everyone, it's Brad again here today with another episode of Ask Brick. Ask Brick is my Q&A show here on YouTube where you leave me questions about Lego, about life, YouTube, literally anything at all down in the comments of any of my videos and I answer them up here on video. This is actually going to be the last episode of Ask Brick of 2021 and it's also my 49th episode. That means next year I will be back with episode number 50 and of course that's a huge milestone, so I'll have to do something pretty special. So if you have any ideas or suggestions for what I should do for my 50th episode of Ask Brick, leave them down in the comments below. And with that, let's get right into this week's questions. The first question is from LifeBoatBoy22. What are your brick set statistics and how many sets and pieces do you have? That's a great question. Let's go to BrickSet. I'll go to my sets here. Overview of my collection. According to BrickSet, I own 1,304 items, 1,224 of them are different. My size of my Lego collection is currently ranked 1,800th of all BrickSet users. I have over 327,403 Lego pieces, making this the size of my parts collection currently ranked at 3,832nd. And I have a retail price of 122 sets, for $27,786. So not too bad. I love looking at the BrickSet statistics because it gives you a pretty decent overview of the sets you have in your collection. You know, I go through it and I'll be like, hey, I had that set and completely forgot because, you know, it's somewhere here in my Lego room. The only thing I don't like about BrickSet, of course, is it doesn't account for any of the, you know, pick-a-brick cups or random parts or bricklink orders or all that stuff that you place throughout the year. I would estimate it says I have about like 327,000 pieces. I probably have over 400,000 just because of the amount of pick-a-brick cups and loose brick orders that I purchased and all that good stuff. So yeah, well over 400,000 Lego pieces is still a pretty substantial Lego collection. But yeah, those are my current BrickSet statistics as of filming this video on December 7th, 2021. And I have not yet added some of the sets I got for my birthday yet. Of course, BrickSet's never 100% complete, but that's still a pretty good overview for right now. The next question is from Barry Francis. Ask Brick, do you collect the Lego Creator Expert vehicle like the Porsche or the Mustang? If you do, what is the next vehicle you would like to Lego to bring out in that line? Well, I'll be honest with you. I don't really collect those two sets. It's not because I have anything against them. I just honestly don't really collect them. I think some of the biggest vehicles I have would be like the VW camper van and the London bus. Those are kind of in the Creator Expert line as well, but it's not really like the Porsche or the Mustang. I would say those are honestly two really, really cool sets. I'm not much of a car guy, so that's why I don't have any of those. If I got to choose my dream vehicle for Lego to release in that line, I would say like a black SUV, like a Chevy Suburban or like an Escalade or like a Cadillac One, like the president drives in. That would be a really cool vehicle to see and I would buy any of those. But as I said, I'm not much of a vehicle person, so that's why I haven't really bought any of those luxury ones so far. Ralliston asked, ask Brick, why on earth do you keep your empty Lego boxes? I throw all mine out. I'm not selling any of my builds. That's a great question. This is a question I've been asking myself since I started being a Lego collector in like a serious Lego collector in probably like 2013. Maybe even earlier. I stopped throwing out any of my boxes. I still don't throw out any of my Lego set boxes. Now what I do instead of keeping them assembled, I cut them up and break them down and I put them in a bigger box. But they're all stored. I've got boxes here, boxes there, boxes back home 4 hours away. Like I've got boxes galore. And why do I keep them? I'm a hoarder. I think that's all I can say. I don't really know why I keep them. I don't have necessarily a really good reason to keep them other than I just don't like getting rid of things. I don't plan on really selling any of my sets either. Kind of like he says, like Ralliston says, like I just don't know. I guess I like keeping them because I like being able to hold on to things and you know, if I ever wanted to do anything with them, I guess I have them. I have some of these boxes. These are a little different. Those are more collectible sets, I would say. And I use those boxes for display. Those are harder to break down. Any box that is like hard to break down, like the camera that I'm reviewing, even this one's not hard to break down, but it's the Lego Ideas set. And like the, you know, the Adidas set, I keep all the architecture sets, but I'm not pulling those out. I keep all those sets kind of behind there just because, first off, they don't break down nice and easy. Second off, because they're nice boxes, and because those are the sets that, when they come in such nice boxes, I feel like those are the sets that I'm more apt to display in my Lego room. And I like having the boxes on display. Like, you see, it looks nice in some of the areas where you have the box behind the set. So like any of the sets that have nice boxes, I feel like those are the sets I'm probably going to want to display. The other sets, like, yeah, I'm trying to think, like any Lego City sets, you're not going to see a Lego City box on display here in my Lego room. It's just not, I don't know, it's just not a collectible set. It's not really cool. But again, I don't throw those boxes out. I just cut the seals, break them down, and put them in another box. And I wish I had a better answer for you. I know I just talked for a minute, and I don't have an answer, but it's honestly because I don't really have any real reason to keep them other than I want to. I'm afraid of throwing them out. I want to keep my Lego collection as complete as possible. And yeah, and I'd never even think of one day selling my Lego collection because that's not even in my cards, but I guess like it helps having the boxes. I don't know. Very, very bad answer. I'm really sorry about that. Chad Boats asked, "Ask Brick, do you have any hobbies besides Lego?" No, I don't really have. I guess like my hobbies include like, you know, student governance and hanging out with my friends and stuff like that. But other than Lego, no, I don't really do any hobbies. I used to like photography. Now I don't really do that other than when I see cool things and I take them on my iPhone. You know, I like to travel, but I wouldn't really call that a hobby. But other than that, like besides working and hanging out with my friends and doing Lego, that's kind of my life. I don't really have any other hobbies. I wouldn't have time for another hobby or anything to really occupy my time. Lego is like my number one, and that's the one I want to stick with, and, you know, hanging out with my friends and doing my student governance stuff. So yeah, no, unfortunately don't really have any other hobbies, but I'm also, I don't know why I said unfortunately, because I'm not too upset about it. I'm pretty happy with my Lego hobby and what I do, and my life is very, very busy, so I don't feel like I'm unfulfilled or anything like that. So I'm doing okay. Be Kind All The Time said, "Ask Brick, what do you suggest doing to get bulk Lego parts and collections? Do you go to a used Lego store, the Lego store pick a brick wall, local classified ads, yard sales, garage sales? Just wanted to hear some great tips on getting good priced Lego." That's a great question. I've kind of, you know, acquired my Lego collection through all of those different methods throughout the years. If you want just Lego fast, like just parts that you can build with, I would definitely like go to Walmart, get some of the Lego classic sets, go to your pick a brick wall, get a bunch of random parts there. I would honestly start with some of the classic sets just to get a whole like backlog of Lego parts, because the pick a brick wall are more specialty pieces, so you're probably not going to get what you're looking for there. But the Lego classics lines are really good of just like having a bulk bunch of sets. They have a lot of different ones with different parts for different kind of themes, stuff like that, wheels, windows, doors, all that great stuff. However, if you want like more of an eclectic taste of Lego, and not just the basic parts and a bunch of random colors, kind of like what you would get in a classic, definitely get used Lego. That is the best way to get a lot of parts fast. Lego parts and Lego collection. You could go to a used Lego store. Again, a lot of those are probably not, maybe like they'll have better pick a brick selection and like pick a cup or whatever they want to call it. You'll get a bunch of different parts, and it's not like the quantities you get at the Lego store where you can get 100 of one part, no problem. This might be like 100 of one or two parts, if that makes sense. So they would definitely be a good place to go if you're fortunate enough to have one. I am not. I would say the best places would definitely be local classifieds, like Facebook Marketplace, Kijiji if you're in Canada, Craigslist in the US, any of those sites, just because those people like throw stuff on, you know, look for larger collections, stuff like that. That's where I got a lot of things throughout the year, you know, talking, if you have friends and family with kids that currently have Lego, like, put a bug in their ear that if they're ever going to get rid of the Lego, make sure they call you, stuff like that. I've had really good luck on Facebook Marketplace, where I've just kind of scoped things out, see how things go, you know, contact people that are selling like Lego collections and stuff like that. Some people have no idea what the value of their Lego is worth, so you might be able to get some pretty good deals, fairly, of course. Other people have watched, you know, and read way too much online and try and get top dollar for a used Lego collection. I personally like acquiring bulk Lego collections, and I haven't done one in a few years, actually. I've got a few collections over the years that I've kind of immersed into mine, but I haven't done that recently, and I love doing it because you just get so many random sets and parts and minifigs and stuff like that. A lot of that you never buy yourself. You could never afford to buy the set, and it's honestly a little bit nicer when you get a big box of a bunch of broken down sets. If I buy a used collection of all the sets completely built, odds are I'm not going to tear any of those sets down, rebuild them, and then put them in my Lego room. I'm either just going to put them in or I'm going to tear them down for parts. So I kind of like when I get just random bulk sets of like half-built sets, lots of loose pieces, stuff like that, because then it's fun to kind of scour through and see like what different sets you might have in your collection. But like I said, just from knowing people throughout, you know, throughout your life, family, friends, things like that, maybe post an ad on Facebook or being like, I'm looking for Lego, and definitely checking your local classifieds. Those are the best places I think you're going to end up getting a lot of used Lego for a decent price. Man, now I want to get on Facebook Marketplace and see if anyone's got any Lego. I miss the days of getting a huge collection and spending weeks and weeks and weeks sorting through it, because that was always a lot of fun. This question is from BNSF Rail Fan. Ask Brick, Lego seems to be canceling police sets. Why instead don't they give us any Lego train sets? So that's like not entirely true, because they just released the 2022 Lego sets for the Lego City line recently, and then you saw from my reaction video, there were a ton of Lego City sets in that line. They're all awful, but there was a ton of them. So I don't think Lego's really canceling police. I think they put a hold on it back in the summer when things were really heated. But I definitely don't think they're canceling them. In terms of getting train sets anymore, I think Lego does. I'm pretty sure I just saw somewhere that a Lego Creator train is coming out soon. Lego does do, I would say, a fair amount of city trains. Every few years, they kind of release a new system, stuff like that. I would say we do get kind of a fair amount of trains, and of course, there is only so many trains that they can do. I mean, I haven't got a new train in a few years now, but I'm looking over at my Lego collection. There's a few there. Instead of focusing on trains, which we do get every few years, and police, which we unfortunately get like every year or every other year, I wish Lego would focus more on Lego City things. Like they're doing a little bit of a hospital. They could do more. I want to see more stores. I want to see a school. I want to just see more from the Lego City universe that's not trains and planes and police. Like, I don't know. That's my thoughts on Lego City. You guys watched the whole 18-minute video, I think it was. Like, I talked about them quite a bit. So you've got my opinion there. But yeah, no, Lego's definitely not canceling police sets. And, you know, we could get more Lego train sets coming very soon. I don't know when the next one will be, other than the Creator one that I think I saw on Twitter yesterday. I don't even remember. I didn't look that closely. But yeah, that's my answer to that. They're not canceling police, even though everybody kind of thought they were. But all right, everyone, thank you guys so much for checking out this video and this episode of Ask Brick. As I mentioned, this is episode number 49, which means next one is going to be episode number 50, the big 50. So you'll definitely have to let me know down in the comments below anything special or anything you want me to do fun for that episode. I don't want it to be like a regular, typical Ask Brick episode. I want to do something crazy. So anyway, thank you guys so much for checking out this video. If you did enjoy, please don't forget to leave a like, comment, and of course, subscribe. Looking forward to seeing you here on my channel for the next video and more Ask Brick coming very, very soon. All right. Thanks, guys.